After 3 years of relentless work, I have finally done it! I, Lord Andres the Mad, High Lord of Lursis, Harbinger of the Spiffening, Level 24 Boxless Madman, Cutest Rocket 2013, and all around neutral guy, have passed the goal of 200 subscribers. My growth has not been quite as steady as I would have wished for. I'm still very thankful for each and every one of you who is willing to spare the time to my content. And if you actually enjoy it and are not simply developing something similar to a Stockholm syndrome. So I should say thank you, and I will. Thank you. Now, as it has almost become tradition, to celebrate, we will clean things. Yes, I shall gather me and myself, and we shall clean up a real big mess, if you know what I mean. But as you can see, we're gonna play some Viscera Cleanup Detail. Yeah. So, let's request a little solo job. Yeah, I don't have any save files. I haven't done any of this before. We're just gonna grab, like, a level. And can I, like, randomize what I want? No? Alright, in that case, we're going to Gravity Drive. I have no idea what that is. What are the game rules? Disable sniffer time limit. No, this is cool, this is cool. Let's play. Now, as you may know, I have previously played the option that was, Viscera Cleanup Detail Shadow Warrior thing? Where we cleaned up the, starting scene from that game. Oh. Of course. Why did I expect anything else from a level quite clearly named after the place not being entirely, inappropriate gravity? I still have gravity, but that might be because of some sort of boot enhancements. Where can I get water? Because as you can see, the mop, it's not very clean anymore. And to be fair, it's quite filthy. So I need to clean my mop before I stick it against anything else, because we know what happens. So I'm just gonna run back and forth looking for water. See, there's already a bloody foot stain there now. Probably because that's where I landed when I jumped, maybe. What's this blue crack thing? Well, whatever it is, we need to clean it up. Okay. There's still really no water here right now. Was this the water machine? Because I think that's just a rubbish machine, isn't it? Like, you get a bin for rubbish like this. And you just put stuff in the rubbish container. Well, clearly this is not the place to start the level in. Oh, well. As you can see, this just enables those pins. Yeah, there's a foot there now. Okay, what is down this hole? It looks awfully like space. Right, this is the box of foot stuff in it. To claim it as your own. I'm not entirely certain this was the wisest choice of level. But maybe there's a water bucket down this corridor. Behind all this gore. We made it into deep spaces by the details of the operation and by initiating phase 2 when suddenly everything went wrong. The mission was going perfectly, like a textbook. We opened the gateway, then everything changed. Didn't know what happened, everything went dark, and then I heard voices. They were calling to me, screaming in a strange language. I think one of them was my wife, my dead wife. The other crew members have started seeing things as well. God help us. Okay. Well, I'm no god, and I need to disable that, you know, preference here. I'll pick up highlighting, like, that's actually quite bothersome. Okay, so what's in this corridor? Whoop. Very well, apparently there are parts in which you can actually, you know, just float around. Or casual-like. Does this deliver buckets? No. It's a vendor thing. What's that? First aid supplies, solar flare. Nah. No, this is not what I need. I need a bucket with water in it. Ah, here it is. The magical artifact. You know what? This was a terrible idea. We should not have gone here. Where's the incinerator? It's quite clearly we need an incinerator. Oh. Hello. So, I'm not instantly forced back to the ground, if I don't want to go to the ground. That's good. That's an elevator. I don't need an elevator. What I could benefit from maybe is a hatch that enables me to throw things into space. Like... open the airlock. Just throw things in there. Did I just fly? Whee! Not quite what I had in mind. Thinking more along the lines of... how do you throw these? I guess it's less a matter of throwing and more a matter of letting go while moving. That seems to do the trick. Okay. I want to see if I can empty it up. I can. So this is what we have instead of an incinerator. Good to know. Now we'll be able to start actually cleaning the place up. Yeah, this is already too bloody now. Not what I had in mind. This is what I had in mind. Of course I will have to throw that into the thing as well. Into the airlock. Mind you, I should also clean up the airlock in that case. Open this, take a bucket, and let's hope the thing never runs out of buckets, because as we can see, these are one time use only. I'm just gonna make ourselves a nice little path to the thing. And I'm gonna open the inner doors already, because that means I can toss the buckets in there. Toss the buckets. Toss the buckets. Remove the buckets from this plane of existence. Alright. I can basically already do it like this, you know. If I try to put it solidly on the ground and then move up. Oh, for fuck's sake, now I just fucked it up completely without even effort. Any effort at all. Goodbye, Bucket. Hello, Bucket. I need your help. You see, we're trying to clean an area in a zero gravity scenario. I would not at all be surprised if there was actually an option to, you know, get me some nice little gravity in here. Like a small little switch or something, which I just haven't located, because... Where's my water? Give me that water. Fuck you, Bucket. Alright, next bucket then. View bobbing it is amazing in this experience, because it just gives you that whole, this is a desperate attempt to clean up a zero gravity area. Perfect feeling for that. Oh yeah. And that's too bloody, I think. Okay, next bucket. I wonder if there's a way to actually not spill them. Well, other than the theory mentioned, which, you know. Why is this still bloody? You know, the theory already mentioned that there might be a switch for gravity around. Yeah. Alright. Well, maybe if I do that, like... Oh, I still spilled it. But that could have worked. That could have worked. We're making progress here. We may end up with a scenario where we don't need a new bucket for each, you know, thing. And can I pick this thing up? Because it doesn't look like an actual thing. Oh, it was, you know, just loose blood. Because of course it was. It's your gravity, it doesn't really need to spill everywhere, anywhere. But the fact that it has is just a mark of, you know, the devil. Which makes it very surprising that the water stays in the bucket as well as it does. Wait, I need this. Yes, no! I need to learn how to switch between the tools fast enough that I can turn the bucket upright as I throw it. Or before I throw it, or whatever. Okay, let's just clean up this bloody mess. This is progressing well enough. I'm surprised, actually. Like, we found a bucket dispenser. We are genuinely learning how to bucket without completely destroying the bucket. Oh, there we go. Still managed to spill it. And yeah, it's going well. I say as I splatter blood back onto the thing. That was a really big mess there then, because where did this leg come from? I didn't need this leg. I needed a bucket. No! That's not where you're supposed to go! You're supposed to go there. Thank you. Look at all this blood now. Like this dispenser, this is so bloody impractical. Oh, oh my god, did you see that? Did you see that? Holy shit. Okay, I need to place it back securely on the ground. Yes. So it doesn't spill over. But as you saw, we made genuine progress towards where the fuck are you going? We made genuine progress towards learning how to use buckets in zero gravity. And it's amazing. That's the bloody blood. Get out of the air, blood. How do I mop up flying blood anyway? Like, it's an issue. It's a real issue. Like, okay, now it's gonna make its way to a surface. So that'll help. Whee! Alright, well. Progress is being made. I'm mastering the arts of picking up items and throwing them into the airlock. And you know, as they all say, space, it's where you throw the trash. Okay, now I'm gonna have to close the door for a bit because the mess is trying to get back outside. So it's gonna be a matter of depressurization. This is really bloody, and that's a spillage. Whoopsie. Let's repressurize that. How do I clean the inside of this though? Because that's like glass. I have no idea how blood got in there in the first place. Like, I can't even clean this. Alright. I hope the outside isn't too big of a mess, because I don't know if I have to clean that as well. Because, you know, that may be a really big mess. Whee! You know, messes that big, then those just might be troublesome. Oh my god, that's... This was Barney. We went to the same school together. But back then he wore a purple dinosaur suit. It's really weird. Never expected someone to wear purple dinosaur suit, to be fair. Can I just slap it or something? I can. Okay. Slap that as well then. Okay, that one doesn't want to work. Let's grab some of these balls. Balls. I have no idea what sort of balls these are, but you know. They're going in the airlock. As does this arm. I will have to clean up the airlock as well at some point. But I think I'll leave it for last, for obvious reasons. Such as the fact that it's really difficult to clean up when I'm just throwing body parts in there every once in a while. And you know, once I get to actually cleaning up the corridor, it's gonna be a lot of blood. Can I just get rid of this blood flying around? No. Oh, hello. Goodbye. What's this? It's a pack of crisps. Delicious. Probably doesn't have enough chili there. Or jalapeno or whatever. Chili and lime chips are really good though. Yeah. No, it was chili and cheese and jalapeno and lime, I think. Maybe? I don't remember. Now, clearly, I need to refresh my memory by going out and buying some spicy chips. Yes. These are just fat so crisps, though. So, they're probably not very good. They're probably just, you know, there for the purpose of just being there. Yep. There's some real blood stains here, and it's like someone just walked in from a really weird corridor or something. What is a boombox? Can I just... Yeah, that works. No more crisps. No, to be fair, it's an empty box. Alright, well, the music box is my new companion. Oh, and he managed to spill the blood on the floor. Whoop. And it managed to attack me. Can't quite say that I was expecting that. He's hoping it won't find the airlock because, you know, he's my companion now. Like in some games, you have companion cubes, in this game, you have a companion radio. Or companion boombox. It's a very happy thing. Here's hoping it doesn't get covered in blood, because that would be a mess. Also, here's hoping it won't spill my bucket. Oh. Saying things like that make me feel like a walrus. I do hope it's not, you know, catching blood from anywhere. Because that would be rather unpleasant. Okay, there, it's coming now. Ooh, I need to catch this carefully, carefully. Turn it upright. Put it on the ground. Oh, you fought me some chips! How nice of you, companion boombox. Very nice indeed. Eee. Clean up this little place. I hope my head won't splatter blood anywhere. Alright, jump up again. And oh no. There we go. Oh, it's tilting. It's tilting. Rotate it upright. Put it on the ground. Yeah, I'm doing things. I'm learning. Yeah. One day I will be the best space janitor ever. Today is probably not that day, but one day. One day. How did this blood get in the ground? Don't tell me you went in there. No, I didn't see it. It might have gone on a space adventure. Though inside the facility, well. It is bound to happen eventually. Where did these bloodstains come from there? Let's be fair, it is probably a boombox being all mean. That door is splattered against the ceiling and I spilled something. Yeah, like that. Yeah, this is looking rather nasty by now. Alright, next bucket. Alright, next bucket. Oh, I think the music box is coming back. From its adventure. Oh, and we need the next bucket. To be fair, I haven't actually cleaned up this mess here yet. So if there's like random blood there, it just might be from there. Alright, I'll clean up these items from here and then I'll flush the airlock again. Sounds good. Just throwing things into the furnace is so much easier though. What are you doing up there, Note? Come up, come on. What is this? Something has gone very, very wrong. We can't get anyone on the high gain and no one knows we're out here. I'm going to try head out the airlock and repair the bot and then a cluster if I can. Also, I've started seeing things, faces outside the windows. I don't know what to make of it all. Well, I make of it that this is garbage. Like that piece of paper. I'm just gonna clean out the entire place. And it'll be like new. And they'll just have to refurnish everything. And, you know, probably... Oh, that's where it ended up. And probably just, you know... clean things up. Well, Move the space station to a different location then. That'll do. So the garbage outside the space station currently just won't be their problem anymore. Because that's how tactical janitoring works. Janitoring. Yes, okay. We close the door and keep the pressure. More much. Beautiful. But you know, depressurizing is actually, you know, enough of a bunch to deal situation that it just shit gets momentum, yo. Shit gets out of here. That's all we need. That and the boombox. Mind you, we cannot lose the boombox. The boombox is invaluable to our janitorial efforts. You know, I could probably run with this. Whee! Oh, where did this cloud come from? Weehee! I forgot there was a running function. The game is on default on always run, but I like to sprint shift, like shift sprint. So that's why I've been casually strolling about until now. Just because I like to casually stroll about. Yup. No, 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 you go in there like a badass motherfucker. Alright, cool. Yeah, where did the pack of crisps go? They're probably plotting a rebellion! I will not stand for it. There will be no rebelling crisps on my territory. Let me grab this bucket as well. And barrels even. Get in the airlock! Come with me if you want to leave! Because that's the opportunity I give you. Alright, now, there's the pack of crisps. Please tell me you're in the pack of crisps. No? Where are you, my sweet pack of crisps? I think they're actually gone forever. They're probably not actually gone forever, they're just plotting their my demise somewhere. Because that's what packs of crisps do. They are pure evil. What is this blue stuff? Do I clean that up as well, or is that just damage? It appears that's just damage. Okay, how do I splatter this blood out of the air? Like that, apparently. That's gonna cause a mess. You, legs, come with me. Yes, that's exactly what I had in mind. These are really shiny pants. Look at those pants, so shiny. Wow. Mighty shiny pants. I didn't expect to see these shiny pants anywhere. Really? Ooh, that's a lot of blood. Yeah. I need to clean this fucker up. Which means I need a bucket! Whee! Oh, that's where the back of crisps went. Come on. You're leaving! Oh, I was hoping to hit the legs. Oh, come on, you little sweet bucket of water. I missed. And I missed again and just spilled the water. Great. Whee! Get in there.
Get me another bucket. This is, of course, a premium bucket. It's one that I will not spill. Observe, as I spilled it, without getting my mop clean. Yeah, that's what I was gonna get. Ow, my fucking... That's actually really frustrating. I should have gone with something with gravity. You know. Might have been easier.